In Enola Holmes 2, Enola uses her expert sleuthing skills to uncover clues and connect loose threads in the case of missing matchstick girl Sarah Chapman. But did you know the Enola Holmes 2 filmmakers also hid secret details and clues throughout the movie to treat fans with keen investigative eyes? We're about to show you every Easter egg in Enola Holmes 2.
These clues have been planted for us to find.
The movie starts with Enola being backed into a corner with a subtle reminder of what she learned in the first movie.
You're not alone.
That's right. Though at first glance Enola may appear to be on her own, a closer look shows that Eudoria is right there with her, on a wanted poster. We hear in the movie that business is booming for Lion Matchstick Factory.
Henry Lion turns all before him into gold.
But how popular are they really? Well, if you look closely, you'll notice that even Sherlock is a customer, and he's not easy to please.
Oh, but it's such a mess.
It's perfect. Don't touch anything.
One of the movie's most memorable scenes is when Tewksbury asks Enola for fight lessons, and she teaches him to
avoid the punch, make the counterpunch.
But in the heat of the moment, Tewksbury doesn't remember what Enola told him, and gets the lesson backwards, throwing a punch first and taking a counterpunch on the chin as a result. Ouch.
Ow!
Enola chased evidence all over London to finally end up at the Paragon for the movie's climax. But following the simple rule of X marks the spot might have helped her avoid a lot of effort. One of the shafts of light in the Paragon casts an X-shaped illumination on the seat where the evidence she needs is hidden.
X marks the spot.
Though Enola doesn't have time to dwell on her feelings as her investigation turns deadly,
is he?
Stay unemotional.
Color is used to show a clear shift in the tone of the film. Case in point, the first time Enola is chased by police through streets and alleyways, the day is warm, sunny, and bright. After May dies in Enola's arms and we revisit the same chase, the atmosphere is much colder and darker.
You've seen this before.
Characters in the film also use color to communicate. Eudoria wears a purple petticoat during the carriage chase, and purple is the primary color in her flyers. This is no coincidence. Purple was the first color used by the British suffragists. And did you notice all the red and white sprinkled in costumes and props, like Bessie's red scarf, May's kerchief, the Sweet William flower, and Eudoria's red pool balls and white eggs? That's right, the egg is an Easter egg, and could have helped you crack the case. How? The recurring red and white is a nod to the importance of Lion's matches changing from red to white, which is a key clue for Enola. The Enola Holmes 2 team also had fun sneaking themselves into the movie. Composer Daniel Pemberton plays the conductor at the Paragon, while editor Adam Bosman's picture is used to portray the dashing Reginald Swain, and his son's image was used for the newspaper illustration of the Camden Cutthroat. The Society pages feature members of the post-production team, both in the Wild Night with Oscar article and as the bottom three eligible bachelors. Are they trying to tell us something? Crew members also appear throughout the end titles of Enola Holmes 2. For example, the ad for Curtis and Lawrence lozenges is for Matt Curtis and Matt Lawrence, who created the film's graphics.
Congratulations!
Recognize that dog? Director Harry Bradbeer has snuck his dog Socks into the Enola Holmes series on a few occasions. We see Socks on a poster when Enola wanders backstage at the Paragon. The same poster is where Superintendent Grail's first shot at Enola strikes later in the film. Socks also appears in the newspaper Pooch Persuader ad as Pavlov's dog, with director Harry Bradbeer playing Pavlov himself. Beyond posing as Pavlov, he then put on a Scottish brogue to play the announcer at the matchmaker's ball.
Pray silence for His Lordship Viscount McIntyre.
And put on a Cockney accent to voice a prison guard.
Exercise, 15 minutes.
Harry also lent his voice to the paper cutout detectives shown in the animations.
Yes.
Mackenzie McIntosh.
Hey.
Sir Alfred Hornblower.
And those are all the Easter eggs in Enola Holmes 2. Or at least the ones we can tell you about.